the game. Ellie has to learn how to forgive Joel for what he did, and then she has to learn how to forgive Abby.
He did nothing wrong.
No.
He did nothing.
He lied, though.
Yeah.
So, okay.
About revenge. It is a story about forgiveness, which is much
more
interesting.
No, it's a story about revenge.
It's about
it's
revenge.
Definitely it's a story it's about revenge. Revenge.
Yeah.
Bad things happen to those who don't go all the way to revenge.
Aside from this scene, when is like the idea of forgiveness ever reinforced by the game?
Like, not even when Dina and Ellie are in their farmhouse together. Dina never appeals to the concept of forgiveness in order to stop her from going out.
Yeah,
like,
she
no,
was
it's a
like,
very not, pragmatic.
It's
bad.
And also, like, I like how Ellie has to forgive, but Abby doesn't get to, like, she should just forgive Joel.
Again, this is the huge problem with the game. Abby kind of gets away with it.
Yeah.
And you again, people are gonna be like, no, she didn't, though. She got, it's like, she got away with killing Joel. That's the point.
Yeah, the others didn't get away with it.
Yeah, no,
but she
did. The others got their fucking hardcore just desserts, I suppose, for being complicit
best parts
in the
game.
Sadistic torture and killing of a person that they didn't even know was fucking a wrongdoer. So yeah, they got what they had coming, but she didn't. And she's the one person that we would want that for. And he's like, I don't understand why you'd feel that way. It's like, oh. Okay.
I just don't. How do you? He has no ability to understand people at all. He's just like a weird psycho. You can't have money, and he can't understand you. It's just, oh fuck me. Bit of a psycho. Not gonna lie, that's how he comes across.
Mm-hmm. Interesting to me. If you got to this scene and you thought that the best narrative choice is for Ellie to kill Abby,
yes,
then I truly cannot fathom how you consume stories.
don't even go there, buddy.
Yeah, we're not dumb, man. You just don't get us. You do not understand our perspective, and you cannot empathize with the people who are criticizing this game.
That's a pretty common one, honestly.
If you're him, yeah, go ahead.
I was just going to say that this perspective is pretty common. It's surprising that he has no idea how to empathize with it.
Yeah, I was about to say something pretty similar. Is like, if you're making this video and you see that everyone is super upset about this, like, pull a couple of them to the side and be like, why do you feel this way? Because I don't feel this way, and I need to understand why you feel this way because I'm making a video about it. He's like, nope, I am correct. I don't even need to understand why. No, I don't even have the ability to understand why people feel differently than me. He's like, wow, you come across as a bit of a psychopath, honestly.
Can't get down on our level, man. No.
Because to me, this was never a revenge story. I never saw it that way.
Then I have no fucking clue what to tell you. Like, this is
insane.
Let me explain to you how it's a revenge story. The opening inciting incident for our protagonist is someone taking revenge on someone, and then she spends the entire game taking revenge slowly on the entire group that did it to her, and then someone tries to take revenge on her and is stopped by it, and then she decides to take revenge once again on this person, and then stops doing it. The big faction war that's happening on the other side of the campaign is all fueled by taking revenge on other actions that are made. This is a story of revenge. I don't know how you missed that.
It's got revenge everywhere, to the point where when we were watching it and playing through it, it was just like, it's so on the nose.
Like, there's a scene where Abby's chilling with their buddies and they're like, oh, remember the truce? How did that end? Well, they killed some of our guys, but we killed some of their guys, but that was because they killed some of our guys. It's like, it's so obvious what you're doing in the game.
Oh, wow.
So, someone said it's a revenge plot. It's like, it's a revenge story. They're making points about revenge.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just a plot line that's involved, and besides, it's several plot lines that are getting digged in, as well as all the little notes you pick up about different stories about taking revenge. Remember Owen's story? The fucking Seraphite was like, I'm just done with it, man. Like, I don't want to, just enough of this sort of thing. It's like, oh, another perspective about how revenge just is not as satisfying or violence in general. Which, again, if someone said it's a story about violence, I'd be like, that's fair. Violence, revenge, forgiveness, you can throw them all in. But to say it's not about revenge at all, I'd be like,
that's fucking nuts.
The forgiveness aspect comes at, like, the 11th hour, and again, it comes out of nowhere. Like, there's nothing building up to her forgiving Joel. It happens at the finish line. It's like,
it's about family, and that's what's so powerful about it.
Amazing.
Abby both suffer immensely for the things they've done wrong. Abby takes revenge on Joel, and it causes all of her friends to die. Then she's tortured.
Which isn't her to die. Note, it's a little bit of a difference. Other people dying, not the same as her dying.
I like that it's her problem that they're dead, not their problem that they've been killed.
Yeah. Jeez.
Cosmo's fucking big-ass brain, man. He's evolved as a critic.
I like that he's
also willing participants.
He treats them as characters as much as he should, probably, because they're all paper thin.
He's one of the people who says, like, the real losers of war aren't the men who get killed, it's the wives who lose their husbands. It's like, yeah, that's Cosmonaut. That's him. He says that.
And when we see her in Santa Barbara, she's pretty well adjusted. It's not like she mopes around because of all the damage she's dealt to her friends and co-workers or faction leaders because of her decision to kill Joel. So what I mean, the Joel aspect of her decisions barely weighs on her at all. She doesn't see the death of her friends as her fault because she killed Joel. She sees it as
Ellie's fault, yeah.
Yeah, Ellie's fault for not appreciating that she could have had a happy life because they let her live.
Yeah, we killed your loved one in front of you, but we let you live. You should have just let us off the hook right there for that. Ellie loses her fingers, she loses fucking everyone that she loves. Tommy, her relationship with him is fractured forever, for sure. So is her relationship with Dina and, you know, her ability to, like, raise a kid. I mean, what does Ellie have at the end? Can she at least play the guitar? Oh, right. No, she doesn't have the fingers necessary. She doesn't even want to, like, turn the guitar over and play it left-handed, you know? Whereas, what does Abby lose? She loses her hair. She loses her gains. She still has Lev.
But she could still get her gains back and her hair will grow back.
Yeah, exactly. But fingers can't grow back. I mean, unless in Last of Us 3 they want to retcon that too. They might as well, right?
Yeah, why not? I mean, a couple fingers is way different than entire segments of the plot.
Yeah.
What a shit video.
Really something else.
I can't fathom how you guys consume stories.
And enslaved for months and literally crucified. When
she
Ellie
was,
starts
okay,
trying-
so first off, enslaved for months, boo fucking who? Two, right? I don't think you know what being crucified is.
She was
like,
put
it's
on
kind
a
of
stick.
In the name.
It's a Jesus stick, though.
It's a Jesus stick. It's not being not that.
If she were nail treatment, she'd be dead as dead-onia.
Yeah, but instead it's Ellie seeking revenge that leads to Abby surviving. That's weird.
We said this earlier. I'm not buying it. You can't tell me stuff that happened to her irrelevant of Joel is justice for Joel. It's like, nope. Besides, they already said that, he said that Joel was a bad guy anyway, so I don't even know.
If someone kills a loved one of yours, and it turns out that they died 30 years later of cancer, it's not justice?
No, not really.
The important part is her understanding why and knowing all of, it doesn't, who cares? Like, if I fucking, you know, save a baby from being torn to shreds by a guy and shoot him in the head, and someone takes revenge on me for that, I'd be like, why? What's the issue? And, turns out that baby was actually just a cuddly little toy that had a bomb inside it that was going to kill everybody, and that guy was trying to deactivate it, and you killed him. And then that bomb went off and killed everyone. I'd be like, oh, wow. Shit. You know, there's none of that in the game. And it's because the game doesn't realize that killing Joel wasn't actually justified. Or at least not in the simplest of terms.
The scenario that I came up with about, like, how Joel ambushes this family and kills the dad and is hunting the mother and her kid. And it's like, you know, that very well could have canonically happened, even though we're not shown that. But the fact that he dies to Abby, that doesn't mean that there's justice for the horrible thing that he did there. You know what I mean? He didn't die because of that action. He died because someone got mad that he killed her dad when he was going to operate on a 14-year-old and kill her in surgery without her consent.
I need that scene where she says, "You killed my father," and it's like, he threatened to kill me and you can't say my daughter, but he may as well.
Do you ever wonder why? Do you ever stop for 1 second and ask yourself why he did that?
Fuck it, she doesn't know. If he said he threatened to kill me and my daughter, what does Abby say back to that? Well,
I don't care.
It was for the greater good, yeah. Joel. It's like, greater good? Like, I don't give a fuck the about greater your greater good. That's right, we don't even get that. It's like the most basic exchange, we don't even get it. Ugh. And yet, you get all these reviewers who are like, yep, Joel evil, Ellie suffered for trying to take revenge, Abby wins. This is good. Like, what the fuck?
You stupid old man.
Yeah, that helps, doesn't it?
Trying to get revenge, it ends with her having absolutely nothing. She's left with no one. And I really like how both
who,
of these
Ellie
stories...
or Abby?
Ellie,
because Abby's at least
Ellie.
Alive.
Yeah, I guess she's got Dina, sort of?
Well,
no, Dina's gone.
Dina's gone.
Dina got her hands on a U-Haul and was able to get all of her possessions out of the house.
We saw a letter from Dina's parents. Dina's parents must have taken her back home and been like, what happened with that girl after? It's like, no, she's a bitch. And like, okay. And then Ellie's going to turn up in a couple of months or whatever to this house and they'll be like, oh, hey, she's like, is Dina here? And they're like, no. Please leave.
I hate that you are describing what very well could be the opening.
It's probably the case.
Where
would Dina go? If not there, it'd be Jacksonville, right?
Yeah, probably Jackson.
Mirror
so really, she'll just bump back into her when Ellie inevitably goes back to Jackson.
The Last of Us Part 3, it's going to be really endearing. It'll be all about Dina. We'll control Dina. Dina, and it's your choice at the end, you press X to forgive. And your video's been like, I do not understand anyone who didn't press X at the end of the game. The game is about forgiveness.
That's the thing you'd say jokingly.
I hope it happens now. Press X to forgive.
Adventure in the last game. For instance, Joel makes a selfish choice in the first game.
What?
That's insane.
It's not selfish, but okay.
The selfishness of saving someone's life at great personal peril to yourself.
I'd be curious to know what your definition of a selfish act is. He treats this as though Ellie has talked to Joel and said, I want this to happen to me. I am okay with this. It's like, that didn't happen. I'm sorry. I love that the game didn't have that happen because no one can say it happened. All right? Last of Us 1 didn't go down that way. You have to retcon it if you want that.
I think that, like, the selfish thing for him to have done would have been if he just simply killed that one Firefly so he could grab his gear and then he just gets the fuck out of the hospital. That's the selfish thing to do. That's him not risking his own life. He just simply kills the one dude that he has to kill so he can get his shit back. The stuff that belongs to him, by the way. That's rightfully his. And then
think about what was going to happen. So they walk you out into Salt Lake City with no guns and nothing. What is that if not a death? You know, like a death sentence.
By exile.
Yeah, like if I was to theoretically take away Wilfred Brimley's access to high-quality, low-cost diabetes medication delivered straight to his door, then that would be more than me just taking away his possessions.
Exactly. Everybody forgets, like, what happened at the end of the first game. It's unbelievable.
And the game, in this game, really wants you to forget what actually happened.
Well, they do, yeah. They want to recontextualize everything.
They are walking him past the backpack. They are not going to give that to him. They're not.
Yeah, because why would they give it to him? They were just going to use it to kill him all. Which
why not? No, they could just say, okay, we will give this to you once you're out of the hospital.
Yeah.
That would have made it a little less like, okay, they're not totally assholes.
Or they would have just lied to him about Ellie and what they were going to do. They would have said, yeah, we're just going to run some tests. Something. Mm-hmm. They could have done like anything else. Like I said, it's like they followed point for point specifically how to appear. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's so bad. Selfish decision, my ass.
Game, and it damages his relationship with Ellie forever.
No,
but
arguably,
it shouldn't.
This is the thing.
And I don't think it did in the first game.
This is the problem with canon. Like, so if The Last of Us 2 theoretically came out and we got, flash forward by a year and she says, look, It's on my mind. I get it. Something happened back there. I need you to tell me what it is. And he explains all of it into the detail. Not necessarily what we've been over, but at least mentioning a lot of the significant points. And, like, she sighs. They have a conversation about it all, and it calms down a bit. And then they move on. And the story itself is not going to be about that. You could have that. You could have it so it's never addressed again. Literally, The Last of Us 2 could have been about anything. Didn't have to be about this. But because... that's what The Last of Us 2 is, that means that that's what The Last of Us 1 was. You know what I mean? Like they've directed it in one direction, therefore that is what The Last of Us 1 was, which is like, oh. By the way, I watched a review, I think it was Writing on Games, he's talking about the second game and what he likes and doesn't like, and he says that he released a video on The Last of Us 1 like a month before it came out, but it's pretty obsolete now.
Right, because this game has now made that the case.
Yeah, your analysis of the first game is probably fucked by the second game.
You know what the moral of the story between both Last of Us games are? This is how we win. Not saving what we love, forgiving what we hate.